When you're not boxing training or doing your normal work, you pigeon, what do you call it, pigeon training?
A pigeon fancier.
Well, I know it's in the family, and it's gone back a few generations, and you're continuing it.
Since I was a baby, I can't remember that. I've been pigeons around me. My dad's always had them, and I think my granddad's had them, and his dad's had them, so it's gone on for years. I was brought up with them, and then when I got to about 10, 11, my dad bred me some of our own to race with my uncle John Park at my nana's, and started racing there. We didn't win much early on, but then as we went on, we stepped it up a bit and started to compete with my dad at the highest level. I don't really enjoy the day-to-day going in and feeding and looking at your pigeons. I'm more into it for the racing side and the buzz that you get out of it when you win and you see your pigeons come home. I'm more into it for that, where other people just love having the pigeons round them, can sit in the garden watching them fly and stuff like that. I like the racing side. I feel like it's nice to have them round you still, because even at my house now where I am, first thing I thought was, I want a pigeon loft in my back garden when I bought the house, so I don't race at the moment because I'm not busy with the boxing, but I still wanted to have pigeons around me. So I'd say, yeah, it is quite relaxing.
There's a few people, isn't there, with boxers who are, you know, renowned pigeon, Tyson, Mike yeah. Tyson, and yeah, Bobby Rimmer, does it? Paul
well.
Smith,
yeah. Bobby Rimmer, it's good. It was, I think, even Trevor Francis, was it?
Yeah, Trevor Francis.
So there's a lot of sort of
Big
sport.
Duncan Ferguson.
Yeah. Boxing and sports, footballers and pigeons. Mm. Pigeon racing is bigger than people think.
You don't use them to send messages to Teddy to get him to the gym on time?
No more. However, he could probably keep up with them after time. Is that fair at the moment?
You got him into it, Steve, yeah, originally, the pigeons. You got him into the...
Yeah, well, that's not the word, he just grew into him kind of thing. He was always there when he was a baby growing up, so,
Just grew up with him.
He just grew up with him, he didn't know no different. He just thought he'd had pigeons, that's the way life was.
Did he go into competitions, the pigeons? He used to do all that?
Yeah, well, just racing competitions, yeah. But they have, like, a different side of the pigeon game where you show your pigeons, like, fancy pigeons and stuff, but we're on the other side where you compete. That's our game, competing. Yeah. He's been born into competing. That's why when he boxed himself and when he couldn't box through injury, he had to stay competing. So now he's got Terry. Mm. Terry does his competing, and his competitive part of it is making sure he's ready for the fight.
You box yourself as an amateur, doing this now as a coach, does it fulfil that void of when you was doing the boxing yourself? You know, I know you miss competing yourself, and your career ended shortly, didn't it, really?
Yeah. I mean, I've probably feel, when they box right, it's all right going in and winning. Sometimes you get a buzz, but it's not the maximum for me. The maximum is when they go in and they box to the best of their ability. And when they do, that's the buzz I get from it, then is seeing them at the top of the game. If they're slightly below, I'm happy because they've won, but I'm not fully satisfied. When they go in and they reach the potential, that's when I get that proper buzz. Like Dale Coyne, the other fighter, on his debut. Debuts are special for your fighters. You're probably not going to have a meaningful fight again like that for another 10, 12, 15 fights because they're sort of about ticking over and learning. But when he boxed on his debut and he done everything perfect, it gave me that proper buzz again. And it's nice to have it. I think it does fulfil what I miss myself.
What do you miss about competing yourself and the boxing?
Being fit, I think that's the biggest thing. I don't think I miss the boxing as much as getting in and fighting. I think I miss myself being fit. I just think you have a good feeling about yourself. It's nice to know and feel confident in yourself. So
go on.
I think that more than anything. And people might say, well, you still should be fit, you should be training, but it's hard to fit everything in. So I'd say the fitness side of it.
And what do you know about pigeons?
No, I don't know about pigeons, mate. It's the coach, yeah.
Well, Terry, it's the last hard week of training now before this big British title fight. You're just toning it down now for the final week and then you just take over.
Yeah, just had my last spar, bit of pads, bags, port steps and done. All my hard work done now, just rest up now and get ready for the fight.
Fighting in your hometown, Manchester, it's been the career, you've had 24 fights unbeaten, all leading up to this British title. It was your dream to win that. You couldn't have asked for more than that big chance to be in your hometown at the biggest arena in the city.
No, I love it there. I've been to watch Ricky Hatton in that fight there, so yeah, I've always wanted to box there. Ever from being a kid, I've always thought if I could box there, it'd be a dream come true, so to fight for the British title and it's even better. Probably do about 300 tickets by the time it's here next week, so hopefully they'll be all loud cheering, yeah. Looking forward to it.
I mean, this was always the dream, like I said then, and you was aiming for this British title, and that was like the milestone that you just set yourself. It's a week away now. You know, when you go to bed tonight and you're dreaming and you're thinking of this fight and the outcome of it and the certain scenarios, in the end, how do you see it panning out?
Me being British champion, of course. But yeah, I'm looking forward to the fight. Looking for just the actual fight itself, just getting in there and performing and showing everyone what I can do, and at the end of it, being British champion and taking the belt on me.
It's the vacant belt that the ex-champion Martin Gethin standing in your way. What do you know about Martin? I'm sure you and Steve have studied him and looked at his style. Do you know what sort of threat does he pose to you with winning a British title?
Not really. We've watched videos of him. He's just a come forward fighter, likes to come and have a go. But I think I don't see how that can worry me really. So, forward to the fight.
Originally, Derry Matthews had beat Gethin for the title, and you were supposed to be fighting Derry. It would have been a rematch with Derry because you'd fought before in that prize fight. How far did you go in camp training for Derry, facing him?
Well, not really, because I always had it in the back of my head that Derry weren't fighting her, so I thought if Derry won the fight, there was a chance that Martin could get put back in for it anyway, so there was always that in the back of my head. Anyway, so I was just training to get the best out of me at first, and then when we got the opponent, obviously watched and prepared sparring around him and how the fight's going to pan out.
Well, Steve, the dream of winning the British title, speaking to you from the beginning and when you and Terry set out on this journey, that was always, I won't say the final plan, but it was certainly the first stage of a plan that would take you onto a world title shot. You're a week or two off it now.
Yeah,
it's reality.
We've been waiting a long time, and I feel like he's been ready now for about a year. But it might be a blessing in disguise, really. He's 25 now. He's fully mature. He's got all his strength, so I think he's ready. And if we win that title, we've achieved our first goal that we first set out to do 6 years ago now, I think it is. So I know I've looked back at some of our old tapes, and we're forever saying British title this, British title that. I think people are probably fed up of us saying it, but to be honest, it was all about that. That was our goal to achieve. It was mine and Carl Places and Terry Flanagan's as well, so we're nearly there now.
He obviously poses a different set of circumstances than Derry, but that fight that they both had, which Derry won, it was really close, wasn't it?
It could
probably go either way at the end. So.
Derry tired in the last few rounds and Martin Cummins young, and I guess that's what he thinks is going to happen when he fights me, but I know I'm conditioned for the 12 rounds, and if it goes the 12 rounds, I'm more than capable of staying in there for the 12. It does what it does, don't it? You know what you're going to get with him. He's going to come for a fight, and I'm up for a fight, so it's going to be a good fight on the night.
It'd be great testing your skills against someone who has been British champion as well.
Good experience, you can't wait now.
Yeah.
These are the fights I want. This is what I've been asking for, and show everyone what I can do.
It's going to be a fight, because Gethin's always in a fight. It's every minute of the round, Martin Gethin's going to be in the fight, we know that. So I'm confident we can beat him. We know what we've got to do, it's just going and doing it. Martin Gethin's going to make it difficult for us. He always gives it 100%, very durable. And like I said, for every minute of that fight, Martin Gethin's going to be in it.
Well, there's no luck involved in this, is it? It's whoever performs to the best of their abilities and on the night, brings it to the brings it to the ring, and you know, don't leave it in the gym. Is that you know, that kind of way
you
look at it?
Yeah, I mean, obviously you've got to turn up at British title level. You can't turn up and expect to win. You've got to turn up and be on your game. And if Terry does that, I think I can see him winning.
There's no doubts in your mind. No, he's going to win this one.
Easier, but I can see Terry coming back with a title.
You said you've got to let that pigeon go anyway.
Yeah,
so do you wish on pigeons when you let them go? Does that not work? But
no.
Maybe send a message out.
There won't be a wish on this one. It'll be more hard work. That's what'll pay off. But let this one up now, and it'll go and join its rest of its mates in flying.
Where would a win leave you, Terry? Obviously, British champion. You know, when I first spoke to you a few years ago, that was the dream, to win a British title. I know you mentioned Vegas,
but still,
we're not looking beyond that. I suppose that's the.
Looking beyond it, but obviously, if I do win it, when I do win it, it's going to be your ambitions are changing. We'll look for bigger, better things. But for now, concentrating on winning that British title.
Do you know more now than what you did when you started?
You just learn, you pick up stuff, don't you, through going around the gym, sparring with people and getting experience and training hard and training in other gyms and stuff like that. You just pick up stuff and you learn little tricks and little skills and bring them into your boxing, and everyone's still learning. It's a learning game.
Getting ready for a fight, having them 10 weeks training, and now you try and peak at the right time and stuff like that. Have you just trained like this, like for this fight, as you would for all the other like title fights?
Yeah, pretty much. We've done a lot more 12 rounders this time, because we're not, it's a 12 rounder, but yeah, we always train hard. We're prepared for the fight. I would usually prepare, but just had a lot more harder, more aggressive sparring than usual.
I just want to speak to you about Stephen and you two meeting up at the beginning, and you know, that dream we spoke about then was yours and Stephen's dream that you planned together, didn't you? You know, going back them few years now and looking what you've been through together, it's here now, man. It's on the corner. Can you just tell me about Stephen, the relationship you had, and how you started this?
He's always friends, trained at the same amateur gym. He was the main amateur boxer that everyone looked up to. And when he stopped boxing, I carried on boxing, and I felt like I wasn't getting looked after proper, and wasn't interested. I lost a few amateur fights, and I said to him, I'm thinking of jacking it in, and he said, just start letting me coach you, and then we'll see how it goes, we'll give it a push. And then I started letting him train me, first day. Chain me, he's at my house 5 a.m. I thought he was joking, and then ever since then he's just drilled it into me, just hard work, training hard, and I love it. Learning skills, everything, good coach, good learning coach, and gone from there, and here we are now, like 5 years later or something.
Yeah, it's a really close relationship. He's a really, I mean, you're like brothers, really, probably, aren't you? More than mates, you know.
That's what it is.
You spend more time with each other than
that. That's it, yeah. He does everything for me, my diet, nutrition, everything, tickets, ever. Sorts me physios out, anything like that. Keeps me head on it, gets me sparring. Just sorts everything out. I don't do that.
It's a great relationship you got. I mean, both be proud of yourself, how far you've come, and, you know, working together, stuck together. And it's just around the corner, and I wish you all the best, Teddy. Is there a prediction for the fight? Do you do anything like that?
I did say 6 rounds, and I stick by it. I think I will knock him out in 6 rounds, but I prefer to the 12 rounds, so if it goes to 12, I'm more than capable, but I'm going to stick. I'll knock him out in 6.
Well, Teddy, I look forward to the fight. God bless you, and I wish you all the best. Bring that title back to Manchester.
So.